Good morning, dear students. Wish the day brings million happiness and success in your life. So today we are going to learn a very essential organic name reaction with a detailed mechanism, a simple mechanism of helium reactions. Now our entire learning process should be summarized into several parts. First, the definition. You know, dear friends, definition of an organic compound is a very vital part. And after, how a reaction happens can be known from the nature of the reactant. Why all the reactants never respond in same kinds of reactions. Okay? And how these reactions happens, this can be systematically understood through a detailed study of its mechanism and its kinetics, and what kind of energy transfer happens, this can be known from energetics, and above all, what its utility in organic synthesis, specifically the retrosynthesis strategies. Okay, so first let's begin. Can you define what is haloform reaction? Specifically, the trihalomethane compounds are generally known as the haloform. So how it can be defined in a systematic way? It is one of the essential organic name reactions in chemistry, which exclusively and efficiently produces pure droplets of trihalomethane on the treatment with strong alkali and halogen, excluding a fluorine. And definitely, an organic compound must possess a ketomethyl group, or that may be converted into such a group. Now look here. Here acetone, having a ketomethyl group, easily reacts with 3 nascent chlorine under the influence of a strong alkali, potassium hydroxide, and immediately produces droplet of chloroform. And in the ionic layer, you will found potassium acetate. Now the whole entire scheme of the reactions happens through a systematic way. Let's acetaldehyde. This is one and only one aldehyde. Keep in mind, dear friends, it is one and only one aldehyde that responds in this reaction. If we treat bleaching powder, or instead of chlorine in potassium hydroxide or alkali media, it immediately produces a hypohalite, and this hypohalite, after generation of nascent chlorine, easily attack to the alpha hydrogen of acetaldehyde. You know, alpha hydrogen is more acidic, and ultimately it produces chloroform. Similar situation will be arise when violet color iodine flakes is mixed with acetone, the smallest and simplest ketone in the organic chemistry, then it precipitated out droplets of yellow color iodoform. And when we acidify it, the byproduct, essential byproduct, is the acetic acid or the vinegar. Now I'll ask a question, very simple question. How do ethyl alcohol and 2-propyl alcohol respond in haloform reaction? Evidently, from their structure, it is clear that neither they possess a ketomethyl group. Still, halethyl alcohol, sweet smell ethyl alcohol, is the one and only one primary alcohol. Keep in mind, dear friends, it is one and only one primary alcohol that responds in this reaction through the modification or generations of a ketomethyl group. For example, when we add potassium hypoiodide or iodine or potassium hydroxide mixture, this ethyl alcohol is converted to acetaldehyde, because this hypoiodide easily broken and produces nascent oxygen. And okay, now I'll ask question, is it necessary to perform haloform reaction through addition of halogen. So one question, can you give an example of organic compound that gives chloroform with alkali only? Yes, there is also some organic compound. Chloral or the trichloroacetaldehyde is the one and only one aldehydes, that is halogen derivative of acetaldehyde, produces chloroform on treatment with alkali. So without adding halogen from the outside, we can take the halogen derivative of aldehyde. So trichloroacetaldehyde on treatment with potassium hydroxide, it produces chloroform, and this happens because of the higher energetic state. Now let's begin the details mechanism of the haloform reaction. Actually, what happens, through which route the reactions is performed? Well, now let's begin. Let's take an example of an acetone. Acetone is a smallest and simplest ketone. It first automerized to its enol form. And we know, dear friends, enol form is more acidic part. On treatment with potassium hydroxide, the alpha hydrogen is replaced and produces potassium enolate. And this potassium enolate, the alpha hydrogens, as the alpha hydrogens are replaced, the first iodine atoms entered in the alpha carbon, and gradually the entry of the second or the third iodine is very fast. This is because of the strong minus I effect of the iodine, and above all, the strong minus I effect of the keto group. Okay, so what is the summary of this mechanism? The large iodo and the large alkyl group makes the molecule very crowded. That is, the molecule suffer from some strain and remain in the high energy state. Now let's begin details kinetics and energetics of the reaction. The driving force of the reactions is the steric crowding, or the steric assistance is the steric assistance supplies the energy, compel the molecules to react. Okay, so as the alpha hydrogen replacement happens, and you will be very amazed and surprised that with respect to the concentration of halogen, it is zero. The reaction never depends on the concentrations of the halogen. So it is an example, the best example of zero order with respect to halogen, or the pseudo molecular reactions. Okay, now what actually causes this compound to suffer from such reaction? The bulky iodine group in the Ci3 group thins the electron density between carbon and carbon and immediately broken. Now we are in the right situation to draw a energy profile diagram. The energy profile diagram shows that the acid catalyzed halogenation is quite impossible, but this alkali induced halogenation is very fast and stepwisely happens through a transition state 1, transition state 2 and transition state 3. Okay, so we are in the right position. Why we should learn this haloform reaction? This haloform reaction has the potential application in organic retrosynthesis. It is clear from this above picture that trimethyl acetic acid cannot be easily synthesized from the ordinary reaction. Through this reaction we can easily produce. Now at the end of our discussion, so there should be some essential question must be discussed, that why does haloform reaction never happens in acid medium? Why fluoroform cannot be prepared by this traditional way? And which one is the more acidic between fluoroform and chloroform? So dear friends, if you want to learn more details about these questions, so wait for our next video. And above all, it's my earnest request. If you think the video is essential to you, essential and relevant to you, please subscribe our channel.